is a topic. Let's get a couple of questions going. Thank you, Brian.
I want to jump to mind as the logos.
Raphael? One?
Saying something.
He's got one?
Yeah, yeah. Well, if we're using topics, the logos.
What's the subject he's asking?
The logos.
Low, what?
Low guy.
Wow. Now, see why we call him trouble?
Yeah.
All right, that's enough?
That is enough,
okay. Would you not agree, Daniel returned after a couple of years? It's likely he has an insight into this. So before I say something, do you think it would be fair for asking Daniel what he thinks of the logos?
Absolutely.
Would you agree?
Of course.
Well, that's you. Give it a shot.
What is the, I don't know the question. What is the question? The logos? What do I think about the logos? It's good.
What is the logos? What do you want to call it?
Unfolding of reason in a way.
The unfolding
that,
of reason, see?
In a way that gives it names or gives it words.
The unfolding of reason. Is that a good one? Do you think we should get some help to go further?
Sure. Yes.
Who would you call on?
Brad.
Go ahead. See, if this is an unfolding of it, right? It must have a source.
That right? Is eternal.
If it's unfolding of reason.
Like eternally aware.
The eternal way.
No, eternal and aware, or eternal awareness.
And aware.
And
aware.
Aware.
Don't ask me why that's necessary. Thinking pitch of voice. General value, that's probably another reason.
Yeah.
Does the.
Come on, add to it.
I want to say that providence functions through the logos.
What functions through?
Providence.
Okay.
Where are we defining the logos? I'm not sure what the question is. I kind of stuck there.
We don't have one. Continue the thought.
I can't think of anything better than the eternal way, is what you said.
It's an eternal way.
Yeah.
if there is some way, could you say something more about it?
That it's what always is.
Therefore, it's eternal. Okay. Oh.
How about the Logos is the model of creation?
Ah.
Actually, I was trying to figure it out. I bumped into a quote from Plotinus today, and it said that the pattern in nature is a copy of the pattern in the soul, the logos in the soul. But that led me to the question, is the logos the bright shining pattern, therefore, is it mind, or is it higher? Is there that which is the cause of it, which is still the logos, but logos expressed on different levels?
If it is a pattern in the soul, then
we should be able to be aware of it.
Pardon?
Well,
then
what would follow? Well, it might follow that providence can function through it if it's a pattern
okay.
in the soul. That would be one possible consequence.
Or it could be a model of the soul.
Yeah, that would be the model. More?
I don't know. I'd like to know, what is the relationship between logos and truth?
Holding of reason, that is, the logos is the reason to that seeks to know the truth. Is the reasoning that
seeks
to know the truth.
Yeah, okay, then you're doing this, right?
About what is eternal and...
Okay. I'm sure you're thinking.
I'm thinking. The particle usia, I'd like to link it to the particle usia.
More, please. Go ahead.
The forms.
If your daughter was sitting next to you, I'd say elbow him. There it is. Good, good, good. Go ahead, come on.
Well, the model for creation, as somebody said, I'm having performance anxiety here.
Okay, then let me throw something here, okay?
You're sweating.
How does the logos relate to the soul? Well, there's nothing in here about the soul.
Jeez.
Probably it's not necessary. Or it is, and how are we going to connect it?
Just add a phrase.
Logically?
The truth about the self.
What about it?
That would, must the logos relate to the truth about the self? Just add that to the...
Yeah, but how does it relate to the self?
That.
How? How?
Well, that the reason is that the logos is that which seeks to know the self, helps, is that which provides the instrument through which you can seek to know the self. Instrument is that. Or the way.
Is that what we're going to? The unfolding of reason, understanding is the way of the self, as in know thyself? What do you think? Why do you think so?
It makes sense to me that...
Wait a minute. Should there be some... But how can you come to that kind of knowing? Well, thank you for your answer.
Directly? I said directly?
Yeah. I got the markers, go ahead.
That's my answer. What else did you say?
How? Reflecting.
What?
Meditation, contemplation.
You have to do what?
Reflect and contemplate.
What's he talking about?
Dream analysis.
Does that ever help anybody know themselves?
Yeah.
I read something curious today on separating, right, oneself from that which is other, and in doing so, possibly that would be a way of coming to see the self or knowing the self.
Look, he's likely to be right. But what does it mean to separate yourself from other?
Well, from what is not true about the self.
Look, would you agree with this, that there is something obvious we better get straight, and that is all there is all there is self and what is different from the self. Is that true, Daniel?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you go for that?
Yeah. No.
Yeah. No. Go ahead, because...
Well, I don't know... Well, I kind of... I think it's possible that what's different from the self, that it could all... that it's all one. The idea of one... I think there's one self which would include everything. Which would include same and different.
Hmm. What do you think what he said? Go along with it?
It's
Was it clear enough, or would you like him to say more?
Oh, that's good. Can you say more, please?
I think the idea of self includes all that is both self and different. Like, I'm not saying it clear, but I think the idea of the self, there's two-ness there, and I think the idea of self is one. I don't...
Okay, look, I can use that. But, see, when you say to contemplate or meditate on the self, what literally are you doing?
Turning back to that which is, that which is.
Turning back, I can do that. What does that mean when you, like, would you agree everything I'm looking at, I can't see the self?
Well,
right? So everything is different than the self. Or we just, there it is. Or we say, that's foolish. So is everything different than the self?
No.
Well then.
I don't think so. I like not to think so.
Well, talk, come on, help out.
Well, what I mean by right, going back, like you'd be reverting to that which is now being manifested, right? Like, what's doing this?
See, if you want to do, what is doing whatever you're doing? You want to say that's the self? Right? But isn't it likely that whatever you're doing, it's likely that you forget the self? So what would you add? Wait a minute. Did you have a shell?
Yep.
Hmm. Could you describe it?
No.
No? Hmm. But you're sure you got one?
Not that either. Actually.
Well,
but I always answer yes because I know that's what you want. But.
Sir, would you help him? Did you hear the last remark?
That's
no.
He always says that. That's where you want to go, but I'm not.
Yeah, sure. How do you do it?
I don't know how. No.
Help out.
What's the question again?
How do you know the show? You have one? Look here. This is very foolish. This is all over here. It's not worth it. I have a friend of mine who's been just sitting and meditating, and he told me this. He said, I got to look at the self. It's not worth it.
Short-changed.
What?
I said he was short-changed. He's disappointed, huh?
This isn't going anywhere. Look, we're good at this shot. We're good doing this. But we're having a little trouble doing the stuff about the show. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's harder for some reason. It's more demanding.
But
all that sees, hears, and thinks all that sees, hears, and thinks, you know what? Is a whole. It's not parts, pure whole. That's the soul. Or mind itself. Self is better. That's the teacher of Parmenides. What would you have to do to see whether or not that's true or not?
I just want to say, remove all my ignorances.
Remove them all?
You said all that he, all that hears, sees, and thinks. I think we might need to, all that sees, hears, and thinks, I think we might need to back up and like go back to the self again, because it seems like...
See, the first Greek philosopher that ever wrote anything down is that guy. Xenophanes, and he's the teacher of Parmenides, and Socrates learned from Parmenides, right? So it all goes back to this one statement. Now, what would it be like if you just decided to keep this question That's all. What would it be like? Like you're in the now, aren't you? What does it take to ask, what is it that's hearing right now? and seeing me right now. And if you have any thoughts, same thing. What is it that's doing all that? He says, you know what? That's yourself. Now, either you do it or you don't do it. That's all.
Yeah.
And the nice thing about it, it's cheap. Right? You don't have to mail in $10 a month. Is that right? Cheap?
Cheap.
So, have you done it?
Brief periods of
Why
time.
Why briefly? What happened?
I don't know. Now that you're mentioning this, this sounds like a good one to do for more than brief amounts of time.
Yeah. You either do it or you don't do it. If you do it, you know what? Either you do it or you don't do it. But what's it like in that brief time you were doing it?
Real.
Hmm? Real.
Real.
Full.
Real.
Free.
Free. And for me personally, a little bit scary because I have to face that this is not what I thought I was. Profound.
Do we have the same question? Why did he say he just did it briefly?
Yep, you do.
What turned it off?
Right.
Huh?
Quite so. Good question.
Yeah. Like you saw that it works. But then...
Yeah, that's showing down. Well, you and I had a talk about it this morning, and I'll just share with the group that what's been stopping me for the last year and a half is pretty severe panic attacks right after that happens.
Right after that happens.
So we explored...
comes a counterattack.
Counterattacks.
Right. When it's going well, watch out, because what can you expect?
Bada bing, bada boom.
A counterattack comes in. Hey, that's stupid to do that. Get involved in real things.
Yeah, and what's amazing at those times is that everything that I had previously thought was important kind of looks silly.
Yeah, you can easily get wrapped into everything and forget the soul. Forget your question. But why, wait a minute. There's no reason why you can't do whatever you're doing while remaining with that question. Agreed, Donna?
Sure.
And it's cheap. Is that possible?
Yeah, it's possible.
You ever get music?
I don't know. No.
Huh?
No, but sometimes, yes, I do.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, when you get into music, can you also play this game?
Yes, yeah.
What's it like when you play music and you get close to that state?
Beautiful, ecstatically beautiful.
Mm. Should we ask him the same question we asked you? Go ahead.
Well, I thought you did actually.
No, go ahead. You ask him. Go ahead. I'll listen.
Well, we covered a couple of questions. Do you want me to ask Yanni, what happens afterwards? Like the counterattack? Is that what you're asking? Or
I don't know. Just you go your own way.
What's it like?
Yeah, you go your own way. What do you want to know?
spent doing this?
A lot, yeah.
What pulls you up?
There's an experience of like, sometimes it's like, kind of like, there's a glimpse of just like way too much. Sometimes that's what it is. Like,
I can relate with that one.
You like that one? What else you want to ask me?
Overwhelming, right? Mm-hmm. Have you noticed any patterns in? Let's not go there. Have you talked with Pierre about that way too much feeling, or when you have?
Yes and no. I don't know. Yes, I think so. We've talked about counterattacks a lot. Yeah.
I'm not asking for any details, but have you gone into past scenes, for instance?
Yeah.
And what did that do? Were you able to go back and test afterwards and try getting into the same music or the same situations again and seeing if anything was any different?
Do that again.
So after exploring a past scene with you, did he go back and test it again with music or anything else in which you know throws you into that or allows you into that state and see if you could go any further?
Yeah, now that you're asking, I see that actually over the last years, over the years of knowing Pierre, that there's been a development actually what would block things before. Well, how would you say? Like, yes, I think a big development of where I would stop before, or what would scare me before, or whatever it would be before to now, or to certain times. I'm not answering it clearly, but the answer is like, yes, then there's been a big development of where I would pull back or be scared, or I don't know how to say it, actually.
Yeah, but you're doing pretty good.
Okay.
Right, is it? Yes or no?
I agree,
yeah. He doesn't think he's doing very good. What do you think of that?
I disagree with that.
Yeah, me too.
I think I got your
You're point. Making sense, right?
Maybe it's a counterattack.
Pardon?
When he says that I don't know and he's answering and he's putting himself down, that's a counterattack when he comes out and speaks, after he speaks clearly.
Yeah. Oh,
that's a good one.
Right. Good old counterattacks, right? Right. Hey. Go ahead.
I just wanted to ask you, could this have been over the door at Delphi instead?
Do it again.
Could this question have been over the door at Delphi instead?
Delphi. Is that Greek?
The Oracle Temple, right?
That's the game they play.
Instead of know thyself.
This pulled that whole culture together. Quite amazing, isn't it?
I just had a question for Yanni.
Yes.
We heard Jeff's description of that state. I was just wondering if you could give a state give a description of what that's like when you're involved in music and what the consequences are for the music.
Okay. It's happened a couple times, but what came to mind when it was several years ago, but I was in the Republic and I don't know. There was something. It was with the. I can't even remember what it is now. The pillar of, I think the pillar of heaven or the idea in the circles. But the state was like, it would be like coming up to a cliff or something and seeing like standing up on the edge of a cliff all of a sudden. And it was frightening.
Really?
Like an immense, massive, huge, like a huge, immense cliff, you know, the biggest cliff you could ever imagine, you know, like. It's like that.
Okay, but that's really the counterattack part of it, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I mean, through Jeff's question, like, I'm starting, when he asked, have I worked on past scenes with Pierre, that made me think, I didn't think of it as a counterattack, but I can see that that would be a counterattack now. Yeah, that makes sense.
Wait. I have another question if Pierre doesn't. I'll cede to Pierre, but not otherwise.
Fine.
Oh, were you going to go somewhere with that?
No.
Okay. No, it's just, I'd like to know what was it that brought about the counterattack?
I think I saw what Plato could be doing in the book, and or it was something like that, and I saw that what he could be doing, or what I was seeing was just so much. It was just too much. I don't know how to say it, but
interesting. The second part of it was, what impact did that scene have on your music?
Well, that's the thing, I don't know. I don't know if philosophy has had a benefit on my music, as far as what I've created, I don't know about that yet. As far as being open to learning.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Because I understood you.
Would you find interesting?
Well, that it appears it's a hard, it's a difficult thing to put words on the state he came to.
Sure.
Okay. Also, I just know that you did a composition recently that became internationally renowned.
Yeah.
And so, while you're saying you don't know what impact, I don't know, I just wonder about that.
Yeah, I mean, that is not because of the greatness of the music.
Wait a minute. Only because you said that.
No way.
Yeah, really. See, nobody's buying that, so.
Well, I mean, it literally is not a, it's a.
It must really suck.
No, it's not. You guys, it's a melody for a news theme, and it just happened to, like, it's, that thing is not because the music was great. So. I can sing it for you.
Then you can go.
Pierre has sent me back. I'm still really pushing it, but part of his yoga is to, moving up these stairs that he's just drawn, to take what you're already working on in love, like in my case, Lisp, in your case, music. You may already have a pretty high level of functioning with it compared to all of us, but he would say, what would happen if you push it even higher, go to the next level? Has he ever given you that assignment what would it look like to take your music to the next level? And what would it take to do that? Has he ever done that?
Yeah.
What happens if you want to, you don't have to, you know, but I'd like to hear it.
Well, he's opened me up to, like, true excellence in music and showed me some of the most beautiful pieces of music I've ever encountered, and like Beethoven and the Fleur-de-Lis opera, I think that's how you say it. And so I can see greatness in music where I've never been able to see it before, and I can hear things in music that I've never been able to hear, in ways I've never been able to hear. here before, but I haven't been able to create music yet with that insight or learning yet.
What would it take to, like, if you had to break the attempt to do so down into pieces, into steps, what would be the first step towards doing so?
I don't know. I think listening more and reading this book that Pierre suggested. I think about maybe going to like a real school for it. I'm not sure. Yeah.
No. No. Good. Good.
And some of it also isn't it just.
Try this. Oh, go ahead, Dan.
Well, I was gonna say, isn't some of it also just kind of. Being open to whatever is going to, there's that state of, you call it the zone, of having everything, having time sink away and just being kind of one with what you're working on, and just going back to that place as many times and for as long as you can, and new things will start to just come.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so by removing those blocks and spending more time in that space, it's like, I think Arthur Miller said once that it's like the bird comes and sits on your shoulder, but only like when you're ready to work.
Yeah.
So if you are removing the blocks, then sort of by definition, you're going to be more and more getting new things that are going to be coming.
Look, idea counterattack, so. If you, everybody has beliefs about themselves they don't know, that are false. All kinds, see? But you can live your life and things go on. But if you say to yourself, I want to get my goal, it has to be meaningful, because the most sincere you are in struggling for excellence, right? There has to be that element in it, see? Then you'll find you run into a block. It forces that block, keeps you from the goal. Or it lets you have it, but then you can't keep it. Same thing. Now look. Let's assume now the person gets an insight and then goes on and is successful. Okay, good. Look here. Now we say, watch out, because what we say comes a counterattack. What's the counterattack? You see, this belief came when you were a kid, right? Young, at home. You don't know how you came to it, but it's a false belief about the self. But you have to appreciate something else. And that is that there are a whole bunch of people here in your family and culture that if you break through and achieve a certain level of genuine excellence in what you're doing, they don't like it. Because that means they can do it themselves, or should do it themselves. Wait a while. So, you see, when they introduce that problem into your soul, it's like around, see, here's the problem. That's what they introduced. But they also introduced, how dare you try to get out of it? Right? How dare you? Right? So they have all kinds of ways and attitudes that you know that if you went on and to achieve it, you're going to have to face this inner circle. It's like a deep mouth, like a castle, and around it is yes.
So in a way of speaking, isn't this whole battle that you're describing ultimately over an image of the self, whether the path of logos gets to retain the old image of the self, or if you somehow bring forth or create or manifest some excellence in your life, necessarily that's going to change the image of the self. So it's between the two, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, look, see. This is the patho-logos, the sick logos. It has to be there. Because of the existence of these ways that are in our culture and the family, that comes under the heading, if you dare achieve that, you won't be one of us. Right? Hey, you'll leave the clan, you'll leave the family, you'll leave the religion, you'll leave the race, right? You'll become an individual, and that scares the hell out of these people. Well, what's the counterattack is like giving voice to all of these ideas that they kept you. It's a counter, it's their views about what happens to people who try to get out and be themselves. That's the counterattack, see? It's got to be there. It's not something in you that you learned, but you learned it from them. It's their views, collective views. So if you do break through, this is inevitable. It then attacks you. Give it up. Get in an accident. Forget being genuine and being real. Forget all that stuff. Just stay with your success. Won't work. With the logos, there's the pathologos. The more you push being genuine and push something rational with excellence, hey, and break through, you got to deal with this. Now, hey, you know what? What the hell? You know what? You can, break through that. And you have a different view. You have to have a different view of yourself. You see, the first step is false beliefs about the self are irreconcilable with your goals, if they're meaningful goals. They won't fit, so therefore you have the problem. But if you do succeed, right, then you have the bigger problem of the counterattack. Hey, you break through that, you know what you'll get? What will have to happen? A better view of the self.
A truer?
Have
more,
to.
More true?
More true. More real. Or you can, hey, you know what? You can cut it short. You can say, you know what? Whatever I'm doing, day or night, I'm going to keep that question. I'm going to keep that damn question. What is it that sees in it? I'm going to keep that. Hey, I'm going to keep that. And whatever I do right now, then you're shortcutting this whole process. But,
oh, really?
But it's going to surface it all. Because the closer you get to the self, hey, counterattack.
Well, then that's not really a shortcut. It's just a cord dump.
Yeah, you were just kidding yourself. Drop, better drop. But, you know, what we need is a couple of odd volunteers. Who would be a good volunteer? Brent? He has experience? Yeah, why don't you take on that question?
I have.
For how long?
A long? Quite a while.
And do you lose it?
I do.
See, that's the moment to study. The moment you lose it, you want to study that and see what overcame it. So you want to put a description of what it was like at that time. Right. Now, it may take you a while before you recognize you gave it up, but you can go back to that moment. So you're playing that game. No thyself. But in the Timaeus, Plato has the creation of the universe, and he has Zeus, or God the Creator. There are four kinds of gods, right? Called God the Maker. He reflects upon himself, and therefore, in reflecting upon himself, there's an idea of himself that he has. Hey, look here. It's his idea of himself. That's the model for the universe. That's the soul. So the idea in the mind of God is himself. And all creation is nothing other than acting out the implications of that idea. So, what would it be like, therefore, to experience this? Hey, you can't experience that, see? So, taking that idea in the mind of God and expressing all its inherent intelligibility, that's the Logos. And then among humans, it drops down to unfolding reason.
And so, where does justice fit in this?
Pardon?
Where does justice fit in this?
Oh! Justice is the greatest of all ideas. Jeez! See, if you can see the fleeting moment that all is the unfoldment of the self, then everything that's going on fits perfectly. What does that mean? Then you're seeing that what is just the way it is and should be exactly what it is, given what's going on. That's justice. Curious?
Say that again. What is justice?
If that's true, does that mean all the bestiality that we hear of and know of fits perfectly?
Yes.
Curious, isn't it? Yeah.
Yes, but seeing in the fleeting moment the perfection of the unfoldment of the self, can we relate that back to the definition of logos that
right.
we arrived at?
That's right.
Which I believe you said something along the lines of,
that's right.
given the Creator God is the expression of the inherent capability of the idea of the Creator God,
yeah.
how is that idea of logos and this idea of seeing perfection in the moment of the unfoldment of the self, how can we relate those two?
See, what's remarkable in the Chimaeus, the first paragraph of creation where this is being described, the last sentence is, this shows the providence of the gods. Therefore, the whole creation is providential. What does that mean? That means everything that's going on, there's a goodness that descends throughout to all intelligent beings, precisely where they are. All they have to do is see it. That is, what they are is exactly where they should be, given all their learning, all of their experiences.
And the logos
put them exactly where they are.
Right.
And in that sense, it fits perfectly.
And that's the intelligibility.
Yeah.
And the logos would just be an expression
right.
of that.
And to see that, you have to see how the logos and the pathologos, the sick beliefs about the self, become a part of the mixture. Therefore, wouldn't you agree this is a good time to quit? See you tomorrow.
Thank you, Pierre.
Thank you, Pierre.
Not leaving until I have a talk with Alex. You know Alex?
Yeah. All right. Okay. I'll tell him to get a hold of
yeah.
him. Maybe he'll call
yeah.
him back.
Yeah. Look here. What's Sunday like?
Just like any other day.
Where am I Sunday?
Sunday you will be at the baby shower.
Oh, the baby shower.
Between 11 and 1.
Right after that,
so
or during it, or sneak away.
Not
or
during.
Away.
How about before?
I want to visit a fire, and I'll go, I know where you